Hello and welcome to the third web lecture of the fourth module of the MELDE project, which concerns e-safety. This module aims to present a range of scenarios and ways to stay safe online. The e-safety module consists of five topics, which are risk and responsibilities online, protecting personal data, digital copyrights, online misinformation and harmful content, and cyberbullying. As part of the second topic, which is protecting personal data, we are going to discuss about issues like creating and keeping strong passwords, the importance of update the anti-malware software and operating system, the vulnerability of mobile devices and ways to keep them secure, malicious emails, as well as protecting personal data on social networking sites. In this topic, you will be introduced to the most common security measures and also ways of protecting personal data on social networking sites. Let's start with strong passwords. Creating strong passwords for your online accounts is one of the most effective ways you can protect your personal data and information and keep yourself safe from cyber attacks. In order to create strong passwords, you can use passphrases rather than passwords. Also, use passwords that contain uppercase and lowercase letters, numbers, and special characters. Use passwords that are more than 8 characters in length. Avoid using easy-to-guess words or alphanumeric combinations, for example, names of your children or pets, birth dates, addresses, social security numbers. It's best if you use non-dictionary words. In order to keep the strong passwords you created safe, you should not store them in your laptop or PC or your mobile device. It's also safer if you don't save your passwords in your browser. Also, don't write your passwords down. Instead, try to memorize them. Try not to use the same password for more than one account or service. You can organize your passwords in logical groupings in order to be easier to remember them. Also, avoid sending passwords or account login credentials over public or unsecured Wi-Fi networks and change them immediately as soon as a security breach is found. As cybercrime is increasing, it is important to download and install the latest updates of your anti-malware software and your operating system. Most anti-malware companies are very quick to add protection for new threats and update their protection. If you're using security software for a long time and haven't updated it often since then, it's almost as good as not having anti-malware and antivirus software installed. As long as security software stays outdated, cyber criminals are able to find bugs and issues to exploit. Also, virus writers and malicious code engineers are constantly finding ways around new technology features and holes to operating system, only help them in their efforts. If your computer or laptop is infected with a virus or malware, it could affect not only your data or hard drive, but spread itself to other devices via network links or emails. Some additional benefits to regularly updating your operating system are to repair security holes by software patches and by the fixed or removed security bugs, add new features to your devices and remove outdated features from them. Also, another benefit would be not staying behind from the technology involvement by using outdated programs and applications that are vital to your success at school, at home, at work, etc. Finally, updating your operating system and software can fix the bugs discovered after the release of an operating system, program, or application. Hackers nowadays are targeting smartphones and mobile devices in order to gain access to personal information from text messages, Facebook, and other social media applications, banking and shopping data, email messages, etc. In order to avoid or recover from such an attack, smartphone and mobile device users can lock their phones and devices by using the password protect capability that all smartphones and smart devices have and change the password every 3 to 6 months. An easier alternative to passwords is a lock pattern and a face, voice, or finger recognition. Also, in order to keep your smart device secure, you can turn on tracking so that if it gets stolen, you can check its location by using this feature. In addition, you can lock your device remotely with a tracker application. It is important to update the operating system and software of the smart device. Make sure to download your smartphone's latest updates in order to close down vulnerabilities that hackers may discover. In order to keep your smartphone secure, you should also be careful with applications. Make sure you are downloading apps from the App Store for iOS or from Google Play for Android. In that way, you can verify the authenticity of the apps. Also, you should be cautious with text messages and emails from unknown sources. Don't open any messages from a stranger, an unknown number, or a number that seems odd to you, and delete them. Make sure that you don't click any links or download any apps from the message. Next, be mindful of the risks of using free Wi-Fi, as they may be unsecured wireless networks. If you're not using your device provider's internet service but a Wi-Fi connection, you run the risk of exposing your data to hackers. Ensure that you're connected to a Wi-Fi hotspot that is owned by a business. Be aware that free Wi-Fi hotspot might be owned by a hacker who may be able to steal personal data in crowded areas. Finally, make sure that you have antivirus protection. Your smartphone has an operating system that is like a mini computer and needs protection from hackers. Now it's time to discuss about the signs that will give a malicious email away. First, check if the sender of the email is incorrect. That means if the address doesn't match the name of the sender. Then, check if the domain of the sender's company is correct. In order to be able to check this, your email client must display the sender's email address and not just their name. Afterwards, check if the sender is not aware of your identity. If the sender doesn't address you in a way that you would expect, he probably isn't aware of who you are. For example, your bank would normally address you with your full name in an email, not just in a generic way, for example, dear customer. Another sign to check is if the sender's signature matches how he would usually sign his emails. After, check if any embedded links have suspicious URLs. A way to do this is to hover over the links in an email before you open them and look if the destination's URL matches the site that the email refers to. A good way to identify a malicious email is to check its spelling and grammar. If the email is full of spelling and grammatical errors, like someone has used an online automatic translator for your language, it's probably a malicious email. Finally, check if the content is believable. If the email is promising to deliver great gain in return for small investment or for free, it usually is a phishing email. If you accidentally clicked on a malicious link, do not enter any personal data or login credentials if required, as cybercriminals will use them to log in to the real accounts. Disconnect from the internet as soon as possible by switching the network connection off on your device or by unplugging the network cable in order to contain any malware infection. Then, scan your device with an antivirus and an anti-malware software with a full scan and remain disconnected from the internet while scanning. Finally, change your passwords on the real site or anywhere you're using your email with the same password and back up your files in a different device. Social media is a great way to express opinions, read news, keep in touch with family and friends. However, it's important to be aware that the information you share on social media could get into the hands of cyber criminals, advertisers, and third-party applications that may not have the best interests in mind. So let's discuss about the ways to protect your personal data on social networks. First, avoid filling out the About Me fields. Most social media networks like Facebook keep their About Me sections optional. Consider giving only general information or simply leave this field empty. Acquaint yourself with the privacy settings. Explore the privacy settings and try different options to find out what suits your preferences. Try to limit post viewing to specific people that you trust. Bear in mind that even if you set them to private, some photos may still be indexed publicly in Google image search. So if you don't want your images found publicly, simply do not post them. Be sure to friend people you know and trust. The more people you befriend on social media, the harder it gets to control the information you post. Do not hesitate to use the block feature if you're afraid that a person might take advantage of you and your information. Avoid using the tag into some location feature. Some criminals might take advantage of you and even do you harm if they know exactly your location. Some criminals might even break into your house if they know you're away from it. Log out of a social media site when you're done. If you're using a public device for signing in or even your own device, logging out of a social media site helps to ensure your account won't be hacked by another person having access to the device you were logged in with and verbally attack your friends, post embarrassing content on your behalf, or even worse, change your personal information, your password, or even lock you out of your own account. Create strong private passwords. Strong passwords use a combination of uppercase and lowercase letters, numbers, and special characters that are easy to remember but tough for other people to guess or crack. Avoid using easy and common passwords like birth dates, anniversaries, and names of your pets. Keep your passwords private, and if you have to write them down, keep them secure and away from your computer. In this web lecture, you were introduced to the most common online security measures. We also discussed how to stay safe on social media, how to keep mobile devices safe, and ways of protecting personal data on social networks. In the next web lecture, we're going to discuss about digital copyrights. If you have any questions, you can find us at the Melde Project's website. Also, you can find this material in the project's e-platform. Thank you for listening.